Yo, what's cracking YouTube? It's your boy Professor Crypto. Got another hot crypto class for you guys today. This one's on fire. You guys already know. Anything we bring on the channel, it's got that heat, got that potential, and it definitely should be watched. This one is no different, guys. Without further ado, let's jump right into it. Class is now in session. This one is called Bityard. Now, guys, we've done several videos on Bityard in the past. I want to bring you some really important updates with their platform. Namely, guys, the meat and potatoes of today's video is the fact that Bityard has launched their spot trading beta on their website, guys, and the news gets even better. Guess what? They're partnered up with Binance for the information security, and all of that can be verified right here, guys. You see Binance's logo right here where it says order book, and if you go to the side, it says that that's our liquidity provider. Wow. Bityard and Binance partnership. I never thought I'd see the day, guys, but it's such good news, especially for anyone who uses Bityard or Binance. I mean, now both paths are going to be interchanged, interoperable. All of the beautiful benefits from Binance you can see on Bityard within your account in their spot trading area. Just to remind you guys on what Bityard is all about, they are a digital assets trading platform focused on offering fast, easy, and safe contracts and spot trading. This Singapore headquartered exchange is regulated and licensed in multiple leading markets around the world. An emphasis on simplicity and accessibility makes Bityard an ideal service and platform for anyone looking to enter the derivatives market. Now, guys, going back to over here, spot trading their beta version on bityard.com. One huge thing that I wanted to highlight is the fact that there are no security compromises with Bityard, especially now that they're working with Binance for all of their information security. That leads into this article that I wanted to show you on coinbureau.com. Is Bityard safe? This is one of the most important questions that any trader can ask. The safety of your funds and the security of the exchange provides paramount importance. So how does Bityard stack up to the rest, guys? Well, there are a number of things that we'd like to individually look at when we're asserting this. This includes the exchange security, licenses, risk management, and user-side security. If we move into the regulations, the first thing that you should note is that Bityard has licenses from 4 different country regulators. These include the likes of the United States, which is very hard to obtain, guys, just saying, Estonia, Singapore, and Australia. We can see all of their license numbers on their website here, guys, as well as the date of issuance. These regulations are important as they show that Bityard has the authority to operate in these regions as a money service business. So you can be sure that they will not be running away with your funds. In terms of exchange security, guys, given that you are sending cryptocurrency to the exchange, you'll want to make sure that they're protecting your coins. This is why Bityard uses multiple wallets stored offline in cold environments. Cold storage is perhaps the best way to protect the funds from a hacker, as it cannot be accessed from the internet. Bityard keeps the majority of the funds in cold storage, with only a smaller portion in hot wallets that are used to pay withdrawals and take deposits. When it comes to market risk, Bityard is not like other leveraged exchanges in that they do not have an insurance fund. Instead, guys, they have real-time risk auditing and risk management tools that monitor market positions and exposure. Communication security. As you will have noticed, Bityard has full SSL encryption, which means that whenever you are sending documents or communicating with them, it is a secure connection. We can see that with the certificate information, guys. It's intended for the following purposes: ensures the identity of a remote computer, proves the identity of a remote computer, and then we see our IP addresses below. We can also see the certification authority statement details. This is a great way for you to spot phishing attempts, guys. If you land on a website and do not have the security padlock in the browser, it means that you are most likely on a phishing site. You have to leave immediately. And Bityard is not one of those sites, guys. So you get to stay on Bityard and trade all day. The user side security. Very often, guys, you are the first line of security with your account. That is why it is great to see that Bityard has provided tools in order to protect your account from being compromised by a hacker. The first of these are two-factor authentication. If you bind your phone when you log in, you'll receive a text message to verify the login. This means that even if the hacker has your password, they cannot log in. Another level of security is to set up a PIN in order to be able to accept withdrawals. This is one added layer of protection and could prevent any sort of unauthorized withdrawals from your account. Do take note, though, that your PIN has to be different from your password, guys. Now, guys, another article I wanted to touch on today is written by Mr. Michael Hung. That's my boy at Bityard, guys. He's a great guy, so smart, and he writes some bomb-ass articles, I gotta say. This one's titled, Spot Markets Target Top-Tier Exchanges While Derivatives Gain Market Share. Guys, keep in mind, this article was published about 3 months ago, a little while ago, guys, but nevertheless, I wanted to bring it to your attention. July saw a major shift towards top-tier exchanges on spot markets, while derivatives volumes continue to eat into spot volumes market share. Crypto Compare's cryptocurrency exchange review for July 2020 has been recently published, giving an insight into last month's exchange volume data and trends. Key points of interest include a flippening of sorts in the spot market, with the majority of volume now being traded on top tier rather than lower tier exchanges, and derivatives continuing to make ground on spot markets as they gain overall market share. As Cointelegraph reported, Crypto Compare also publishes an exchange benchmark which ranks more than 165 global spot exchanges. Exchanges which are graded AAB are considered top tier, while those graded C to E are considered lower tier. In July, top tier exchanges saw an increase in trading volume of over 42% to $334 billion. Lower tier exchanges, however, saw a comparable drop of 38% to $224 billion. Top tier exchanges now represent 60% of the total volume, effectively reversing the position in June. Spot volume on top-tier exchanges saw a new high for the year on July 27th, with $27.1 billion being traded. July 27th also saw derivatives trading hit its highest daily volume of $46.91 billion since the market crash in March, and saw Deribit's daily option volume set a new all-time high of $585 million, almost tripling the previous record of $196 million. Derivatives volumes increasing 13.2% in July to $445 billion, while spot volume decreased by 0.5% to $639 billion. This has resulted in derivatives gaining a 3-point overall market share increase to 41%. Despite these relative gains in July market share, figures for both spot and derivatives volumes are still down from previous in the year, following a significant drop-off in June. That's some very concrete information, guys. I really like the fact how Michael highlighted the fact that they're chewing into the spot trading market. Now, what they've ultimately decided to do, guys, is full-on chew into the spot trading market by adding this option on their website. Now, again, guys, it's only in their beta phase, but it is a huge hit already. People are using it all the time. It's very, very easy to use, guys. On the left-hand side, we can see all of our trading pairs, and you can sort them from all. You can go to DeFi tokens or POS tokens, whatever you want, guys. I have it on the BTC USD trading pair right now. And again, we can see all of our beautiful Japanese candlesticks here and the chart, as well as all of our tools to use that with. We can see our order book on the right hand side, all of our buy and sell orders and our recent trades. Very easy to do your limit and market trades, guys. And you can easily do a deposit from these buttons here. And then if you want a contract, you can also do contract as well. Contract is available in its own tab over here, but they also have a link here, contract. And what you'll be able to do, guys, is of course set your percentage of what you want to sell. Very easy to do, guys, just by dragging this bar to the 25%, 50%, 75%, sell or buy, whatever you want to do, guys. All of your open orders are going to be here. Your order history is going to be in this tab. Your trade history is going to be here. And of course, your funds history is going to be here as well. Very, very interactive tool, guys. Attractive for the eyes. Easy to use. I like it. I advocate for it. Don't forget about it and give it a try. Shout out to all my students, guys. I love you. Shout out to the Crypto Class gang. Shout out to the Lambo gang. Shout out to the Whale gang. Shout out to the HODL gang. Thank you for always your continued support, guys. I really appreciate it. If you guys enjoyed this video, please be sure to smash that like button for me and drop a comment in the comment section below. Please remember, guys, we are an impartial channel, so whether your opinion is negative or positive, we'd be more than happy to hear it. That being said, guys, class is now dismissed. We'll see you in our next video. Professor Crypto, out.